Hello friends, in the current video we will work out the problems of company accounts under that issue of shares concept. In the earlier video I have explained you the journal entries and the procedure of writing the entries and every concept basic crux I have explained you. And in this current video I will take up the university based questions and how the university questions will be asked and how you need to work out the problems. Very simple questions, you can easily secure marks in this area. So we will see the Osmania University 2018 question paper. In this, question number 7th was asked for 4 marks, right? Kalyan Limited issued 1000 equity shares of ₹10 each at a premium of 1 per share, payable 3 on application, 3 on 4 on allotment, which includes premium, and ₹4 on first and final call. These shares were all subscribed and money due was received. In the sense, there is no call scenarios. All the money we have received. Write journal entries in the books of the company. Quite simple question. You can easily work out this problem, right? Provided you must know the journal entries. So do watch my earlier video, the number 1 video, first video on issue of shares, where I have explained all the entries. Please go through the video and do see this video, then you can easily deliver in the examination. So I'll explain this question how to work out. So as you are already aware, the share price is 10 and 1 rupees premium. So together company is going to collect 11 rupees in the form of application, 3 rupees in the form of allotment, 4, which includes 1 rupees premium. So together it is 7 rupees and the final call is 4 rupees. Together it is 11 rupees, of which 10 rupees towards capital, 1 rupees towards premium, right? Now we will work out this question. Already I started writing the journal entries, right? So first journal entry, when we receive application money, on the receipt of application money, first we receive application money, right? Hence the first entry would be bank account data to share application. So we have issued 1000 shares on which we are collecting 3 rupees. So 1000 into 3, 3000 we have received, being application money received. And the second entry, transfer of this application money to share capital. Hence the entry is share application account data to share capital, the same amount. So first in application we receive money, then it will be transferred to share capital. Next, share allotment due entry. What is that entry? Share allotment account data to share capital. So how much on 1000 shares we need to receive? How much? 4 rupees, out of which 3 rupees towards capital and 1 rupee towards securities premium account or share premium, one and only same, that is 1000 into 1 rupee. So 1000 towards premium, 3000 towards capital, together it is 4000. So this is the entry. So here we have segregated the amount towards capital 3, towards premium, that is 1001 rupee. And the next, receiving entry, on receipt of allotment money, the entry is bank account data to share allotment. So share allotment account opened when it is due and will be closed when we receive the money towards allotment 4000. Right, being share allotment money received. Right, once allotment is done, now share final call. The entry is share first and final call account data. So we are passing due entry to share capital. So that is 1000 shares into, on final call how much we are going to receive as per the question, we are about to receive 4 rupees on final cost. So the same 4 rupees, therefore it comes to 4000, right? Being share first and final call money due, then we need to receive on receipt of money. On receipt of money, what is the entry? The entry is bank account data, share first and final call, that is 4000. The same amount is received, there are no calls in arrears. So in this way we need to pass the general interest, right? So very simple, very easy to write the general interest. So this question was asked in the Osmania University 2018 question paper. Now we will take up the next question paper, that is 2019 paper. So this question paper is 2019, that is previous question paper. So in this question paper also, 1-4 marker was asked in the university examination. See this question number 4. Dhanush Limited issued 2000 shares of rupees 10 each, payable 3 on application, 4 on allotment, and 3 on first and final call. All the shares were duly subscribed and amount received. Pass general entries in the books of company. Very simple, simple and easy to pass. Just how many entries we have passed? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So how many entries? Application 2, allotment, 2 entries, right? Then first call, first and final call, 2 entries. Collectively 6 entries we have passed, right? So in this way, the same way, we need to prepare the, we need to write the general entries for the next question even, right? So how many issues? 2000 shares, each share of rupees 10, application 3, allotment 4, and first and final call 3, no premium. Even it is a very simple question, right? Generally, we can easily work out this problem. So we'll pass the entries. So the first general entry is, this is our question paper was July 2019 paper. So short question, 4 marks question it was asked for. So the first entry, bank account data to share application. So how many shares? 2000 shares, each of rupees 3. Sorry, each of rupees 10, but on premium we are collecting 3. Sorry, on application, very sorry. On application we are collecting 3 on application. So 2 3s are 6000 we are getting. So 6000 on application. Then share application. Share capital, so that is again the same amount, 6000, right? So next, allotment due entry, there is no premium, so therefore share allotment account data to share capital, that is 2000 shares. On each share we are collecting 4 rupees towards allotment. So 4 to the 8000 each, right? Then as the question says that all the shares were subscribed and money received, hence the entry is bank account data share first share allotment. Now next entry is share first and final call due entry, share first and final call account data to share capital, that is 2000 shares each 3 rupees we are collecting on final call. So it is 6,000 again, right? Then bank account data to share first and final call, that is 6,000 again. So like this, we need to write 6 entries. For this, you will be awarded with 4 marks, right? Now we'll take up the long questions based on this. How the long questions were asked in the university. So now I will take up the 2018 paper. In 2018 paper, so 11th question was the long question. In this, the question was asked, Chandra Company Limited offered to public 20,000 equity shares of rupees 10 each at a premium of 1 per share, total 11 rupees. Payment to be made as follows. Right. So the payments are made as follows. This, that is, on application 2, allotment 4, including 1 rupee premium. First call 2, final call 3. We must check how much this summation comes to. 2 plus 4, 6. 6 plus 2, 8. 8 plus 3, 11. 10 rupees towards capital, 1 rupees towards premium, which is already included in allotment. Applications were received for 35,000 shares, right? So for how many shares we have issued? 20,000 shares, whereas public applied for 35,000 shares. So this is called as oversubscription. The money was received except 1,000 shares on first and final call. These shares were forfeited. Write journal entries in the books of company. So this long question, only journal entries we asked to write. Clear? So very easy to pass the journal entries. Very quickly we pass the journal entries. We'll take another sheet of paper. So already you understood. So the basic crux of this question. Now very fast will work out. So we need to take up one more long question. Right? So 2018 paper. Right? So we'll segregate the paper in two parts. It will be better. Right? Now, first journal entry on receipt of application. I don't write everything, just I will pass the entries. You can easily understand, right? So first entry on receipt of application. The entry is bank account data to share application. Abbreviation have written APP. So most important, how many shares we have issued? We have issued only 20,000 shares. Whereas the public applied for how many shares? 35,000 shares. So we take 35,000. How much amount we have received? 35,000 into on application 2 rupees we are going to collect. So that is equals to 70,000 rupees we are getting on application. This is the most important thing you need to bear in mind, that how many shares we have issued? 20,000. Public applied for 35,000. Hence we receive 35,000 money on 35,000 shares. Then how much? 35,000 into 2, that is 70,000 we have received. But how many shares we can issue generally? How many shares we can allot? Only 20,000, because we have issued only 20,000 shares. Right? Now, next entry. Prior to going for next entry, I'd like to explain here. The question did not mention anything regarding the refund of amount. Question did not say anything regarding the refund of amount. Hence, we presume it as a pro rata allotment. We presume it as a pro rata allotment, and we will retain the money for the adjustment towards allotment. Right? Provided if you can make an assumption in such a way also that company will refund the money even. So either way, it is acceptable, provided you must write a note to the examiner. As the question is silent regarding the refund of amount, whether it is amount is returned, that is excess application money, that is 15,000 application money is returned or not, or pro rata allotment is not mentioned in the question. Right? Hence, we consider it as a pro rata. Now we will do this problem. Now, next entry. Share application account data total amount of application is almost 70,000, you write down first. Then, 2, share capital. How much? You can issue only 20,000 shares into 3 rupees. That is, you can accept towards the application, towards the capital, only 60,000 rupees. Not beyond that. But what about the 10th, what we call, 60,000. So what about the excess application money? Sorry, it is not 3, it is 2 rupees, right? So application money is 2 rupees. So 20,000 into 2, it should be 40,000 rupees, right? Sorry. So it is 40, bear in mind, just you write down here as working note, so that you can easily write the correct amount. But what about the excess application money which we have received, that is 30,000? That should be transferred to share allotment. So share allotment. So we are not retaining the amount, we are keeping the amount, that is 15,000 into 2, 30,000 towards allotment. So we are retaining this amount towards allotment. So we are transferring it to share allotment. So in while receiving the money on allotment, we receive 30,000 less, right? Now, share allotment due entry. Share allotment account data to share capital to securities premium, right? So total share allotment, how much we need to receive on share allotment? On 20,000 shares, we need to receive 4 rupees. So just see, on allotment we are going to receive 4, which includes 1 rupee premium. Therefore total 4 rupees. So 2 fours are 8. Therefore 80,000 rupees is due on allotment. Towards capital, 20,000 into 3. Towards premium, 20,000 into 1. That is equals to 60,000 and 20,000. Right? So this is the journal entry. Next, on receipt. So bear in mind, how much amount we receive? We need to receive total 80,000. But already we have excess application money which was transferred to share allotment, 30,000. So what we can do, this amount we don't receive now, which is already received with us, it will be adjusted. So the entry for that, the entry would be bank account data to share allotment. So share allotment debited 80,000, already credited 30,000. How much we need to receive? 50,000. So share allotment will get closed with 50,000. So we receive only 50,000 from the shareholders towards allotment. That is, already we are having 30,000 pertaining to them, that will be adjusted here. So we have transferred here, right? So next, share first call due entry, right? After allotment, share first call and final call even we have, right? So the entry would be share first call account data, right, to share capital. How many shares? 20,000 shares. On each share, first call is 2 rupees, therefore 40,000. And the most important here is, if you read the question, you will understand what the question says. Application received for 35,000, money received, except 1,000 shares and first and final call money. On both first and final call, we did not receive 1,000. So while receiving, the most important is receiving entry, bank account data, leave this bank, then calls in areas. Account data, in the sense, what, how much amount we are not receiving will be going to call scenarios. to share first call. So total first call we need to receive 40,000, but of which on call scenarios, how much we are not receiving? On 1,000 shares we are not receiving how much? The amount is 2, therefore we are not receiving 2,000. So how much we are receiving? 38,000 we are receiving. Clear? So how we got 38,000? As balancing figure. Sometimes we need to write balancing figure as the amount of journal entry, right? So total share first call 40,000, but we are not receiving 2,000. So how much we are receiving? 38,000. Whichever not receiving will goes to calls in arrears account, right? The next, share first final call, share final call account data to share capital. How much on share final call we need to receive? 3 rupees, that is 2,000 into 3, that is equals to 20,000. These are 20,000 into 3, that is equals to 60,000. So we are issuing 20,000 shares. Next, receiving it. Here also on 1,000 shares we are not receiving. So bank account data, calls in arrears account data to share final call. How much on share final call we need to receive? 60,000. Whereas how much we are not receiving? We are not receiving how much on 1,000 shares, that is 3,000 we are not receiving. In the sense, we are receiving 57,000. That is balancing figure. Clear? So now we have not received first call and final call on 1,000 shares. So what is the company procedure? Company will give notice, first notice, second notice and third notice. Even though they do not respond and do not make the payment, their shares will be forfeited, in the sense cancel, forfeiture in the sense cancel. So the amount whatever they have paid already, that will be retained with the company and that will not be returned. That will be a capital profit for the company. So what the question says, these shares were forfeited. We have cancelled these shares. So we need to pass forfeiture entry. So the entry, share forfeiture entry. What is the entry for share forfeiture? The share forfeiture is, entry is share capital account data. Why we are debiting share capital? Because already while passing the due entries, we have credited the share capital, though we have not received the amount. How much we have to write? Number of shares forfeited. How many shares? 1,000 shares we are forfeiting. Into how much amount we ask them to pay? The total value of share is 10 rupees. So 10 rupees we ask them to pay. That is 10,000. Now the most important, there was a premium. Share premium account should be debited when, if it is not collected, if we do not receive the amount of premium, that should be debited. If it is already received, that should not be considered. Hence, in this case, we have received share premium money on allotment. Hence, we don't debit the share premium account. Instead, to share forfeiture account, to call scenarios account. What is the amount of share forfeiture? Share forfeiture amount would be on 1,000 shares. They paid how much? That is application and allotment. On application 2, on allotment 3. Actually allotment 4. But I am deducting 1 rupee towards premium because already it is received. And it is received, it should not be considered. Therefore, total 5 rupees. So he paid 5,000. And call scenarios is 5,000. The balancing figure, or you can see the call scenarios account. When you see the call scenarios account, first call scenarios debited with 2,000, second time call scenarios debited with 2,000, second time call scenarios is debited with 3,000. This 2 plus 3 comes to 5,000. So debit, it is open, it will get closed by crediting 5,000 here. So this is the way we need to pass the journal entry. So we have forfeited these shares. So in this question, we have asked till forfeiture only, right? If he asked us to write the journal entries of reissue, then we need to pass the reissue journal entries only, right? So, but question is still here only. But I am adding some more extra to this question. If the question says that the forfeited shares are reissued, right? Let's say 10 rupees shares as issued at 8 rupees per share. Presume that this question if says. So generally what happened, forfeiture shares will be reissued at a lesser price. It is not mandatory, they may be issued at a higher price also. So therefore it is 2 rupees less here. So that 2 rupees, as per the Companies Act 2013, it says that whenever you reissue the forfeited shares, the discount amount whatever we give on reissue of forfeited share must be adjusted from share forfeiture account only. So therefore the entry of reissue will be bank account data. So we are reissuing 1000 shares at 8, so we are getting 8000. How much discount we are giving? 2 rupees. So that should be adjusted from share forfeited account data, that is 1000 into 2000. 2 share capital, collectively 10,000. Right? So this way we need to pass the journal entry if it is reissue is given. In this question, it's not given, but still. So once we reissue the shares, what is the balance left in share for future account? We had 5,000 rupees share for future account balance, right? Credit balance. Now here we have debited 2,000. So after the reissue of forfeiture share, how much amount is left over? That is 3,000. This 3,000 is left in share forfeiture account. So this amount goes to which account? After the reissue of forfeiture shares, it is a capital profit. Which profit? Capital profit. Profit goes to capital reserve. Which is capital reserve. So the entry would be share for future account data to capital reserve. That is 3000. Clear? So in this way we need to pass the journal entries. Clear? I hope I made you understand this basic crux. Let's quickly see the 2019 paper even, how the question was asked regarding company accounts. That is long question we are talking about. Very quickly we'll have a look, so that we will do 4 problem we have done in this, so that we can have a better idea for the students to present in the examination. This question was asked in the 11th question again. A company invited the applicants to subscribe for 1 lakh equity shares of 10 each at a premium of 1 per share payable on allotment. Payment was to be made as follows. Application 3, allotment 3, including premium, first call and final call 5. First call 3, final call 2. So collectively 6 plus 5, 11 rupees. Right? So that is 10 plus 1. Applications were received for 1,30,000 shares. Applications for 20,000 shares were rejected and allotment was made on prorata proportionally for the remaining applicants. So we have issued 1 lakh shares, but we have received 1,30,000 shares money. So of which 1,000 shares, of which 20,000 shares were rejected and money was refunded. So leftover is 1,10,000. To them, 1 lakh shares were issued proportionately. This is called as pro rata concept. Right, so we will retain and adjust it as in case of earlier question we did. Both the calls were made and all the money due were received except the final call on 3000 shares which were forfeited after due notice. Later, all these shares were reissued as fully paid for 8.5 per share. Pass journal entries. Very quickly I'll take up, so because already you are aware. So the length of the video is also plays a very important role. Now, when a student wants to learn the entire subject within 5 minutes video, which is highly difficult and not possible for me as well as any lecturer even, right? So please try to understand, this is your career and future. So instead of, as you are willing to invest your precious time on watching movies, at the same time you can watch this video also to learn something and reproduce and get a degree, right? Okay, no problem, that's a personal issue. We'll proceed fast. So we'll allot the place. Sorry, the line is a little bit right, no problem. So first, company issued how many shares? 1 lakh. People applied for 1 lakh 30. So the first entry on application, that is bank account data to share application. Very quickly I'm writing with little bit abbreviations I use. So 1,30,000 shares we have money received. Towards application, how much we need to receive? So payable, premium payable, and 2-3 on application, so 1,30,000 into 3. So 3 3s are 9 3 1s are 3, so 3,90,000 rupees we have received, right? 1,30,000 into 3 3,90,000. So 3,90,000 we have received. It's 3,90,000. Then next entry is very important. Share application account data. How much? 3,90,000 to share capital. So only 1 lakh shares into 3. 3 lakhs. Clear? To bank, how much? 20,000 we are retaining, rejected into 3. 60,000 we are retaining amount, 20,000 is rejected. To share allotment, that is 10,000 into 3, our balancing figure 30,000. Clear? So this is the way we need to pass the gel entry. Next entry, share allotment account data to share capital, securities premium. So total we have in share allotment, how much we need to receive? 1 lakh shares into allotment money is 3 allotment, 3 including 1 rupee premium. So total into 3. So 3 lakh we need to receive, of which 2 lakhs share capital and 1 lakh is securities premium. Right, now receiving entry. So there are no call scenarios, hence the total amount will be received, that is bank account data. How much I need to write? Bear in mind, we have debited with 3 lakhs, already credited with 30,000. So the account is already debited with, account is debited with 3 lakhs, already credited with 30,000. In the sense, the share the people to whom we have allotted the shares, pertaining to them, we have 30,000 already with us. So this 30,000 we don't receive, it will be adjusted. Hence, we will be receiving 2,70,000 only. So bank account data to share allotment. 2,70,000. Please bear in mind, this is a very, very important thing. Now, once this is done, allotment is over, then share first call. Share first call account data to share capital. How much? 1 lakh into, on first call, how much we need to receive? Sorry. First call would be 3 on first call and 2 on final call. So 3. So again, it is 3 lakhs here. But here we have some call scenarios. When I read the question, we saw that both the calls were made and all the money duly received, except final column. Sorry, except final column 3,000. Sorry, not first call. So first call we are receiving total amount. So the entry with bank account data to share first call. So 3 lakhs total we are receiving, right? So now see here, look at here very clearly, received except the final call on 3000 shares. So final call we are not receiving, right? Now final call due entry, that is share final call account data to share capital, that is 1 lakh into 2 lakh rupees we need to receive. But here we have call scenarios, hence the entry is bank account data calls in arrears account data, that is to share final call. So final call 2 lakh should be credited. How much we are not receiving on 3000 shares, 2 rupees, that is 6000 we are not receiving. Total how much we are receiving? 1,94,000 we are receiving. That is balancing figure we can say. Clear? Now what the question says regarding this non-receipt of money? The question says that shares which are forfeited after due notice. So we have canceled these shares, right? So the cancellation entry, share forfeiture entry, that is share capital account data. So in this also premium, we have premium already collected. Therefore, how many shares? 3000 shares we are forfeiting, on which we have called total 10 rupees. So 3000 into 10, 30,000 to share forfeiture, FF I have written, forfeiture account. How much he has paid? 3000 into he has paid application, allotment and first call. So how much he has paid? Either way we can do one thing, two calls in arrears account. So calls in arrears account, if you see here, we have opened with debiting 6000 and it will be closed by crediting. So I am writing calls in arrears 6000 here. So how much it is? 24,000 is to be considered as received. Clear? It is balancing figure. So whenever you find difficulty in calculation, take it as a balancing figure. That will be very easy and you can easily work out the problem, right? So once it is forfeiture is over, then reissue. What the question says regarding reissue? The question says that later these shares were reissued as fully paid for 8.5, in the sense 1.5 discount we are giving. So the reissue entry would be, the entry is bank account data. How much? 3000 into 8.5, then share forfeiture account data. 3000 into 1.5 is the discount, that is 4500. To share capital, that is 3000 into 10, that should be 30,000, right? The balancing figure we can say that is bank, that comes to 25,500, right? So that is over. So reissue entry is over. This amount is we have utilized share forfeiture. So when you see, we had share forfeiture account balance was, we had 24,000, sorry. So we had 24,000 as share for future account balance. Of this 24,000, we have utilized how much? 4,500. How much balance is left with us? Only out of 24,000, we have utilized 4,500. Therefore, 19,500 is left over. That should be transferred to capital reserve. The entry would be share for future account data to capital reserve. 19,500. How we got this amount? 24,000 minus 4,500. So being amount transferred to capital. So I did my best to make you understand this concept. The overall we have done 4 questions. I'll repeat once again, 4 questions we did, of which 2 from 18 paper, 2 from 19 paper, right? Of which one short, one long, Here also two, one short, one long. So short were 4 marks, long for 12 marks. So you can easily secure 16 marks if you are sound in this chapter, right? I hope I made you understand all these things, right? Please do subscribe my channel and motivate me to make more qualitative videos. Thank you for watching and being patient, and do ask, come, do give likes as well as comments as well as doubts, especially is very important. You can ask, I will be very glad to give the answer. Thank you. Do subscribe my channel.